Everyone, I am back. You are right here with me, Meesh, in the kitchen. And today, I'm going to be pulling together stuffed chicken. It's going to be stuffed with spinach and mushroom, okay? So, here we go. Now I have this chicken breast, right? And what I did was I beat it to death, okay? I beat it flat. Bam, bam. Wham, wham. That's what I did. Okay. So after I do that, I actually seasoned it really good, and I let it sit for a while. Okay? Now, to build the actual spinach and the mushroom, what I did was I cut the mushroom up just like that, and then I cut up some Parmesan cheese. It was already finely shredded, but I actually cut it up a little bit more smaller. So you're going to need like a half a cup of that. You're going to need about a little less than a half a cup of mushrooms. And then you're going to need a nice, well, it's like a medium-sized bag of spinach frozen, which you can do. I'm just going to explain how. You can put the frozen spinach in a container like this. Keep the top off slightly. Don't put it tight. You're going to keep the top off. And then you're going to put it in the microwave for 5 minutes. Right? So you take it out. You put the spinach. I would use like a towel. Like a washcloth or something that, you know, not no old washcloth that people been wiping their butt with. Get you a nice washcloth that's new but old that you barely use. Or don't use. That's what I did. I actually used a new one, to be honest. So you're gonna put the spinach inside of it, and you're gonna squeeze the juice out of the spinach. What's gonna happen is when you do that, the rag and the drain goes at the same time, so you're draining out the spinach completely. Okay. And then after that, what you're gonna do is you're gonna put it in a food processor, right? You're gonna add a half a cup of ricotta cheese. You're gonna add the Parmesan cheese. You're gonna saute sweet onions in a pan for less than 5 minutes, okay? And then you're gonna add in the mushrooms, and then you're gonna shred it up in the food processor. Usually you could do it on pulse. It's better to do it on pulse, okay? And then you're gonna get this. This is how it's gonna turn out, right? This is the mix, the spinach mushroom mix. Then, what you're gonna do is you're gonna pull out the mix, okay? And you're gonna put it in the middle like so. You don't wanna do too much because you don't want it to like over spill out. Like that is the worst, when it over spills out. Yeah, it's just, it's the worst. So, you're gonna wanna try to get it flat as you can, but keep it like a good layer. So when you roll it, it's still good. Okay? So then what you're gonna do is you're gonna take and tuck and roll and roll and roll. Okay? Bring it to you and roll and roll and roll. Okay? So now that you have it rolled up, you're gonna stick toothpicks in it to hold it in place, okay? It's kind of like surgery. You're gonna take it from here like this, right? You're gonna grab it like that and then come in. It's kind of like you're pinning it in place, okay? So, you're gonna do like that. And you wanna do it to where it's, you're able to actually put it in the pan, okay? So now there you go. Nice and rolled up, right? So you're gonna heat the pan up. You're gonna put olive oil. You're gonna put olive oil and butter, okay? This pan is gonna heat up. And it's gonna get hot, hot, hot. See, my daughter love catching me acting stupid, but I'm not gonna do that on my channel today. Anyway, so we're gonna wait for it to get hot. It's actually ready, to be honest. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead. What I would do is I would put it in on a side that's folded already. See the side that's folded? That's the side I would cook first. And you just kind of lean it on in there. You might want to turn the heat up a little bit. So we're just gonna wait for it to kind of sizzle up. We're gonna wait for that thing to sizzle up. So y'all see it sizzling? Sizzle, sizzle. Y'all pardon the noise, I'm washing my hands. That's what I do. Dial antibacterial soap, I think is great for washing your hands. Yeah, you see it sizzling? Look at that. It doesn't take long for it to cook because when you beat the chicken flat, it makes it to where it makes the chicken thin. So it doesn't take long to cook. Okay. And also, I season my chicken with adobo, all-purpose seasoning, garlic salt, and accent seasoning. So that was my seasoning for today. Yes, as you can see, it is going. And what I would do, use tongs to check it. Yeah, it doesn't take long, as you can see. You see it's already cooking. And make sure when you put them the toothpicks in that you make it to where you can turn it. That's the goal. Make it to where you can turn it on each side and it cooks. Okay? So I'm gonna go ahead and turn it just so you can see how it starts to look. It begins to look like that. You see how the top is looking? It's pretty. Like I said, remember not to add a whole bunch of spinach so it wouldn't be all out. Remember I told you that? See, look at that. So it's inside. That's what you want to make sure of when you make this. That it stays inside, because otherwise it'd be all in your grease and all that stuff. We don't want that. And so, the finishing product, this is how it turns out. And once you take it out, you can cut it. And as you can see, it looks so good. Perfectly done. Not overcooked, definitely not dry. You can tell that it's very moist, good and done, perfectly done, actually. This is how it turns out. Yes, indeed. So that was just a quick fix. Something I wanted to show you guys how to make. I want to say thank you so much to everyone for tuning in. I always leave off on a really, really good note on my channel. I'm going to say that because I made a post on Facebook and it was mainly regarding like half energies, and I just want to express, like, if you have people in your life that are half in and half out, the best advice I can give you is just go ahead and remove them. I'm not saying don't talk to them again. I'm not saying any of that, but I will say remove them. You know what I'm saying? Because at the end of the day, what you need is things to be whole. You can't live in this life halfway. That's just not how life works. So with that being said, make sure you keep it true to yourself. Stay whole. Keep whole people around you, because that's going to be a benefit to you later, and you know, later down the line. So anyway, I'm not going to give y'all a long speech, but I want to say thank y'all so much for tuning in to Evolving in the Kitchen with Meesh, and I hope you guys have a great night.